I've been living in South Korea for about 8 years now. But after a few years of living in Korea, I found myself feeling lots of frustrations. One feeling I'm having is a kind of lack of control, in a way. I know that I can't control all aspects of life. I can't control other people, I get that. But one thing that I'm really struggling with is people's accountability. People taking responsibility for their actions. For example, I drive to work every day, and I see multiple occasions of people just acting and thinking about themselves before they take other people's needs into consideration. I'm sorry, am I too quiet? Sorry. I feel like, and there have been times where I've actually stopped my car, gotten out of the car, and had a conversation with someone to try and make them understand the action consequences of their actions. Many times these have been dangerous and put myself and other people in danger, and that's, in my opinion, not acceptable. It's causing me a lot of anxiety, and my wife a lot of stress too, because I talk about these situations with her on a daily basis, and it's affecting her as much as it's affecting me. Overall, I want to live a peaceful life, and I want to live like an easy life. I want to know, and I hope you can help me, how can I live with these stresses, and how can I deal with these anxieties that I face when I see people being irresponsible like this? Thank you.
어느 나라에서 사시다고 하셨어요?
Where did you come from before you, Korea?
Where did I come from?
Yeah.
I'm British. I'm from the UK.
네. 중국 가서 한 살아봤어요?
Have you lived in China?
I have not, no. I'm sorry. I'm not like trying to say that life would be any easier in the UK. I don't believe that at all. Like my life is here, and I'm trying to set up my life, and I'm trying to live.
아, 무슨 말인지 제가 알아요.
Okay, I'm sorry.
중국 가서 살아봤냐고.
Have you lived in China before?
No, I have not lived in China. 네. No, this is my first.
인도 가서 살아봤어요.
Have you lived in India?
No.
아닙니다.
그 중국 가서 한 2년 살고 인도 가서 한 3년 살다 오면 이 문제는 저절로 해결될 거예요.
If you go ahead and live in China for 2 years, then go ahead follow that up with living in India for 3 years, this problem will go away.
왜냐하면
And the reason is
기준점을 어디에 두느냐 하는 문제.
It's where you actually, you know, baseline your expectations.
영국에다가 기준점을 두고 지금 한국 사회를 보고 있습니다.
So if your expectation baseline is the benchmark is how people behave in UK and you're observing how people behave in South Korea and judging them with your baseline.
그러니까 이 운전하는 사람들이 법규를 한국이 영국보다 덜 지킵니다.
And that means, you know, basically South Koreans do not adhere to driving norms that the drivers in UK does.
근데 내가 인도나 중국 가서 살아보라는 이유는
And the reason I'm telling you to go ahead and live in China and India
그러면 기준점이 인도나 중국을 기준점으로 하게 됩니다.
Then you know then you actually adjust your expectations and baseline to those that you have seen in India and China.
그러면 한국은 아주 잘 지키는 데 속합니다.
Then in that sense then Koreans are model drivers.
오늘 제가 말씀하는 것은 기준을 어디에 둘 거냐는.
So what I'm saying is, where do you want to baseline your expectations?
Let me take a step back. I've been a homeroom teacher in a private school around here for 3 years, and I have been teaching my students the ideas of responsibility to think about other people before they think about not before they think about themselves, but understand the needs of other people. Because that's what it takes to be, in my opinion, a global citizen, to be a citizen of the world. I try not to compare people in the UK, and actually, I've been watching YouTube videos of terrible drivers in the UK because I know it's everywhere. So I don't believe that Korea and the UK should. I'm not trying to say that they're only bad in Korea, but I believe it's in everybody. No matter where you're from, to be responsible and think about the needs of other people instead of thinking about just yourself. So that's my point, that's my focus, and that's where I'm coming from. I understand that I can't control people, and I can't tell them what to do, apart from my 24 children that I help to guide. But I can't tell them what's right or wrong. I can only show them the door. Maybe that's my answer, but that's where I'm coming from.
다른 사람을 배려하라고 우리가 가르칠 때 사람들이 다른 사람을 배려하는 게 누구나 다 할 수 있는 자연스러운데 배려하라는 거예요. 다른 사람을 배려하라고 우리가 자꾸 가르치는 건 그게 잘 안 되기 때문에 그렇게 가르치는 거예요.
So when we teach others to be considerate of others, do we teach them because they're already naturally considerate of others, or do we have to teach them these lessons because they're not naturally considerate of others?
다시 자기가 영어를 가르치는 거는 아이들이 영어를 잘하기 때문에 영어를 가르치는 거예요. 영어를 못하기 때문에 가르치는
거예요. In another way, the reason you teach English to Korean kids, are you teaching them because they already speak English well or because they're not so good at English?
Yeah, so my job is, yeah, for sure, to help them to learn and to obviously improve their English skills. And, I understand your point, and I think I'm trying to learn myself just to try and understand how to deal with the stresses and the anxiety that I'm facing myself because of my expectations. I know I have high expectations for my students, and they follow that. But my wife and I need to basically learn to deal with my
지금 그 얘기를 하고 있는 중이에요.
So that's why we're discussing.
Yeah.
그 얘기를 지금 하려고 하는
거예요. And that's what I want to discuss further with you.
그러니까 스트레스를 받는데 이걸 어떻게 없앨 거냐 이렇게 접근하면 계속 스트레스를 받아요.
So if your approach to getting rid of your stress is that you already feel the stress and you want to get rid of it, that's not the right approach.
스트레스를 안 받는다면 스트레스를 해소할 필요가 없습니다.
So say that you don't actually receive stress, you know, in the first place, then there's no need to get rid of that stress, right?
그러니까 아이들이 영어를 할 줄 모르기 때문에 내가 영어를 가르친다. 이게 진실이에요.
So the fact is that these kids do not speak English well, and that's why you need to teach them, right? That's the fact, right?
내가 가르쳐줘도 얘는 잘 못한다. 이게 사실입니다.
And another fact is that I can try my best to teach them, but they might not never get good at English.
그러니까 애들이 공부, 영어를 못하는 걸 보고 스트레스 받을 일이 없어. 얘는 못하기 때문에 지금 배우고 있는 거예요.
So there's no need for you to receive stress in the first place just because your kid is not good at English because they were never good at English to begin with.
그리고 얘가 못해야 내가 일거리가 계속 생기는 거예요.
And the fact that they're not good at English actually gives you a job sustainability.
그렇기 때문에 애가 영어를 못하는 거하고 내 스트레스하고 아무 관계가 없어요.
So the fact that kid does not speak English well and the fact that you feel stress over it, actually they're not related.
그냥 못하면 또 가르치고 못하면 또 가르치고 못하면 또 가르치고 이렇게 하면 돼요.
No, you just have to repeat the lesson or try again and again if the kid is not learning his lessons.
그게 내 일이에요.
And that's your job.
그럼 스트레스 받을 일이 없잖아요.
Then there's no reason for you to stress over that.
자기 뭘 잘못 생각하느냐? 못해서 자기한테 배우러 온 사람에게 영어를 한 번만 가르쳐 주면 영어를 잘할 거라고 자기가 지금 잘못 생각하고 있는 거예요.
Because what's causing you stress is that you expect the kid who doesn't speak English well in the first place coming to you to learn English that kid should be good at English because you taught him once.
Right. 자기의 잘못된 생각 때문에 스트레스를 받는 거예요.
So your own expectations are causing you stress.
그렇기 때문에 영어를 못한다는 거를 못하고 있고 얘는 영어를 못하고 못하니까 나한테 배우러 왔다. 나는 그것을 도와주는 사람이다. 이렇게 생각하면 스트레스 받을 일이 없어요.
So if you think of your role as somebody who assists people who don't speak English well into, you know, trying to learn the best way to speak English and you are there to help them, that there's no cause for stress.
So I'm sorry. My point is that because I'm seeing people thinking about themselves more often and acting in a dangerous manner, should I just say okay and just say these people are acting dangerous and there's nothing I can do about that, even if that affects me and my life and my family? Or should I attempt to help them to learn? With your analogy that helps me think that way.
Yeah. 영어 선생일 때는 영어를 못 하는 아이들을 내버려 두는 게 아니라 잘할 수 있도록 계속 가르쳐야 되잖아요.
Right. So if you teach English, you are not just letting kids be ignorant in their English language. You are trying to help them, right, constantly.
그러니까 영어를 가르치지 말라는 게 못 하니까 가르치지 말라는 게 아니라 가르치되 스트레스를 받을 일이 없다는 거예요.
So I'm not saying that don't teach them because they're not taking, you know, to their lessons well. I'm saying that teach them, and if they can't, you know, teach them again, but don't get stressed over it.
그러면 교통법규를 지키지 않은 사람을 봤을 때.
So when we apply this to your original example of traffic, right?
자기는 교통 순경이 아니에요.
So you are not a traffic cop, first of all.
그렇기 때문에 그 잘하든 못하든 상관 안 해도 돼요.
So you have the fully right not to interfere, right, and not to ignore people behaving in dangerous ways.
나만 조심하면 돼요.
And you just can control your own behavior when driving.
그러나 내가 위험한 것을 지적해 주고 싶다면.
But if you want to, and I'll help people learn that they're driving dangerously.
지적해도 저도 좋습니다.
Then you are fully in the right to do so, right? That's your choice.
근데 그 사람 입장에서 생각해 보세요.
But if you look at it from that person's perspective.
자기가 교통 순경이 아니잖아요.
Because you're not a traffic cop.
근데 지적을 하니까 기분이 나쁜 거예요.
And that person probably doesn't feel good about being told that he is driving badly by a person who's not
그러니까
in the authority.
그 사람 그러면 지적하면 그 사람 화를 낼 거예요. 잘못했다 이래 안 하고 화를 낼 거예요.
Then that person probably will get angry rather than accept his responsibility, right? When you tell him that he was driving wrong.
또 그것은 처음부터 내가 지적할 때 저 사람이 화낼 거라는 걸 미리 알고 있다는 거예요.
And that means that you probably know that that person is probably going to get upset if you talk to him.
그러니까 당신은 웃으면서 하이. 근데 너 그 운전 그렇게 하면 너도 위험하고 나도 위험해. 조심해. 이렇게 얘기하는데 그 사람 화를 벌컥 내면 그냥 또 웃으면서 야, 화내지 말고 운전 조심해야지. 이렇게 얘기하면 돼요.
So if that person gets angry, just although you are very courteous in kind of pointing out what he did dangerously, you know, don't get angry in return. And don't get stressed over in return. Just repeat your lesson.
자기가 화를 낸다는 것은 그 사람이 내 말을 안 들었다 해서 자기가 그랬어요.
And the reason you get stressed or you get upset in return is that that person is not actually taking your advice to heed.
그 사람은 자기 말 들으려고 지금 길에 나온 거 아니에요.
But that person is not that person's, you know, job to listen to you on how he should drive.
그러니까 지금 자기가 교통 순경도 아니면서 교통 순경인 것처럼 착각하고 있는 거예요.
So I think you're thinking of yourself as a traffic cop in a way.
Yeah.
그러니까 자기 지적은 해도 괜찮아요.
So it's okay if you tell people that they're driving wrong.
그래야 이게 바뀌는 거예요.
And that's how you actually affect change actually in society.
그러나 그건 저항이 있다라는 거.
But there's always going to be pushback when you try to affect change.
그 저항을 자기가 당연하게 받아들여.
And that pushback is an obvious consequence of your action.
그런데 이렇게 저항이 따르지만은 꾸준히 하면 변화가 일어납니다.
But if you keep on pushing through those resistance, then you will see change.
그러니까 꾸준히 지적을 하세요.
So I think you should continue doing what you do.
대신에 스트레스는 받을 일이 없어요. 그거.
But realize that there is no cause for you to feel stressed.
문 열고 얘기할 때 바로 아 제가 화내겠다 하는 걸 미리 알고 있어야 돼요.
Because you already know that the person is going to get upset, whatever you tell.
화내면 재밌잖아요. 화낼 거다 했는데 부인한테 내 저 지적할 거야. 그럼 쟤 틀림없이 화낼 거야. 화 얼마만큼 낼까? 이렇게 둘이 얘기해가면서 문 열고 하면 야 생각보다 적게 내네. 생각보다 많이 내네. 이렇게 대화하면 뭐 내가 스트레스 받을 일이 뭐가 있어요.
So once you, you know, make a game of wagers with your wife, you know, try to guess at the level of his anger. And if it's lower than you expected, you know, maybe you win some money, or maybe it's higher, then you lose some money.
그러니까 스트레스를 받고 그걸 컨트롤하는 것은 수행이 아닙니다.
So it's not the way of spiritual practice to try to mitigate stress once it already happened.
그건 참는 거예요.
And you're trying to suppress it. That's suppression, not really spiritual practice.
두 번 세 번 참으면 터지게 되는 거예요.
And once you may be successful in kind of suppressing that emotion once or twice, but eventually it'll explode.
수행이라는 것은 실제 사실을 바라보고 있으면 화날 일이 없는 거예요.
Spiritual practice is recognizing what the actual fact or the truth of the situation is and realizing there's no cause for you to be upset or stressed over in the first place.
늘 관점을 그렇게 가지 있어야 돼.
You know, that's the perspective that you should always hold.
That sounds great. 감사합니다.